You got something on your mouth. Other side. Huh? Yeah, sure do. What are you eating? Okay. Still have something on your mouth. Can't come any closer.
The Magic Kingdom. He said the Magic Kingdom, Mommy. What are you doing, Jay? What are you doing?
Right, all of it. danger anywhere in the water, in the bushes, and in the trees. Oh my goodness, it's a giant python. Don't lean out because he'll lean in sure to give you a cargo squeeze and leave you breathless. He's an affectionate creature. Gets a crush on everyone he meets. You know, we do have some safari camps that we can... I guess we're not stopping at this one. Looks to me like we got some uninvited guests. See the one in the back there? Reminds me of my sister. Oh, he's shooting off her mouth. If any of you happen to be wearing yellow, don't make any noises like a banana. They do find it appealing. We're now going down the Nile River. Directly in front of us, we have the African bull elephant. I can tell it's the African bull elephant by its large floppy ears and its sloped forehead. This animal is so large, it's afraid of one thing and one thing only. Does anybody know what that is? No, it's not Mickey Mouse. There she is, his mother-in-law. See these rocks over here? These rocks are sandstone. Don't take it for granted, because it ain't. This is the African belt where all the animals come down, get something to drink and something to eat. These animals in the back here are news. They're here every day, our daily news. And it looks to me like this pack of lions had made a kill on a zebra. And the hungry cleanup crew, those vultures, are waiting for their share. This goes to show the law of the jungle, survival of the fittest. And speaking of survival, looks to me like a native uprising. Native uprising. Not quite sure what the rhino's trying to do, but I'm sure I'll get his point across in the end. See the guy on the bottom? His name's Juan. I hope they don't make a hole in Juan. Hey, at least I didn't say their troubles were behind him. Over here on your left-hand side is absolutely nothing. And over here to your right is Old Smiley and his mate. Old Smiley's the bigger of the two, over 100 years old, and always looking for a handout. Any volunteers? We had one teacher, she volunteered. Now she teaches shorthand. Bam in the back with the white shirt. Do you know what a rudder is? It's behind you. You want to grab it? My wheel's jammed. Thank you. Steer us out of here. That's it. Hold on to that rudder. Steer us out. This is Schweitzer Falls, named after Dr. Albert Schweitzer. Thank you, ma'am. I think we owe this lady a round of applause. All right, that's enough. It wasn't that big of a deal. I was steering the whole time. You know, after being in the jungle as long as I have, you begin to smell. Smell danger, that is. And I smell some danger. Looks like we stumbled into a pool of hippopotami. You know, these guys tipped over 5 boats this week. Only 4 of them were mine. We got a charger on the left. Look out, look out, look out. And a charger over here on the right. Oh well, we're dead. Everybody be quiet, we've entered into headhunting territory. My last group came through here talking, laughing, making a lot of noise. There they are! At least they're still smiling. See these guys over here? You know what they like to do? They like to grab all the women, yank them out of the boat, say, what are you grinning about? Uh-oh, we're being attacked. Man, duck down. Women and children, stand out. Come on, duck down. I'm talking to you. I'm out here by myself. Women and children, stand up. If they throw it back, otherwise you're stuck with it. Those headhunters only have one aim in life, and that's to get ahead. For those of you who've never seen it before, get out your cameras. The backside that is protected by their gods and goddesses, and there's one of their goddesses now. Her name is Shirley. We call this Shirley Temple. Every man, woman, and child for themselves, please keep your arms and hands inside the boat. This could be dangerous. You're all on your own. People do disappear occasionally. Thank you. like we're all here. The sacred Indian elephant bathing pole. Ladies, don't be embarrassed. They're all wearing their trunks. You can always tell the big shot of the bunch. He's the one with his own private shower. And no matter where you go, there's always a little squirt somewhere. Uh-oh, we got a wise guy here. Look out, crew, look out, crew, look out, look out, look out. Oh no, crew! Look out, crew! Look out, crew! Look out, 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 look out,
look out,
look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, look out, and tell you each and everything that I know about each and every one of them. Any questions? The green. You know, everybody always asks me, they say, hey, Skipper Roy, where do we find a souvenir in this jungle? There's only one place to find a souvenir in this jungle, that's by Trader Sam. Trader Sam has recently become the head salesman of the jungle, and business has been shrinking. So he's got a deal, three of his heads for one of yours, any takers? Parents, it's a great opportunity. Anyway, you slice it, you'll always come out ahead. I hear it's a pain in the neck, though. When we get up to the front at the end of our trip, let's all cheer real loud, because we want everybody to think you had a good time. All right, this is the scariest part of our whole journey. Return to civilization. Did y'all have a good time? Yeah! By the way, who's your favorite Mouseketeer? Who's the most famous Mouseketeer? Annette.
Thank you. and tomorrow, the best time of your life. It wasn't always easy. At every turn in our history, there was always someone saying, turn back, turn back. But there is no turning back. Not for us, not for our kerosene. The challenge always lies ahead. And as long as man dreams and works and builds together, these years too can be the best time of your life.
Now is the time. Now is the best time. Now is the best time of your life. Life is a prize. Here and now, you've got it made. The world's forward marching and you're in the parade. Now is the time, now is the best time. We is the time of joy or strife. There's so much to cheer for. Be glad you're here, for it's the best time of your life.
Well, the robins are back. That's a sure sign of spring. What year is it? Oh, just before the turn of the century. And believe me, things couldn't be any better than they are today. Yes, sir, we got all the latest things. Gas lamps, a telephone, and the latest design in cast iron stoves. That reservoir keeps 5 gallons of water hot all day on just 3 buckets of coal. Sure beats chopping wood. And isn't our new icebox a beauty? Holds 50 pounds of ice. Milk doesn't sour as quick as it used to. Our dog Rover here keeps the water in the drip pan from overflowing. You know, it wasn't too long ago we had to carry water from a well. But thanks to progress, we've got a pump right here in the kitchen. Of course, we keep a bucket of water handy to prime it with. Yes, sir, we've got everything to make life easier. Mother, I was reading about a fellow named Tom Edison who's working on an idea for snap-on electric lights.
I'll believe that when I see it.
That's my wife, Sarah.
But with my new wash day marble, it takes only 5 hours to do the wash. Imagine!
That's right, folks. Now Mother has time for recreations like
canning and polishing the stove.
Okay, Mother. You just iron the wrinkles out of my shirts.
Yes, dear.
But no one can improve on nature for drying clothes. Oh, well, the cistern was low on rainwater anyway. Rover, mind your manners. You know, our home entertainment is getting better, too. With his amazing new stereoscope, my son can now see and learn all about the latest events in the world, like the World's Fair in St. Louis.
Wowee! Look at that!
What's the hoochie-coochie, Dad?
Get back to your homework, son. Oh, yes, we also have one of those new talking machines. It plays music right here in our home. You know, the young folks have their own ideas about entertainment. For instance, Jane, our teenage daughter, is getting ready to go to a trolley party on one of those new electric streetcars. She says hayrides are old-fashioned.
Thanks for letting me go, Papa.
Be home by 9 o'clock, daughter.
Yes, Papa.
It's hard to imagine how life could be any easier, but there's a new company working on bringing the same power that runs the trolley into folks' homes. And because those fellas are working that out, one thing is certain.
Now is the time. Now is the best time. Now is the best time of your life.
Life is a prize. Live every minute. Open your eyes and watch how you live. Yesterday's memories may sparkle and gleam. Tomorrow is still but a dream. Right here and now.
Now is the time, now is the best time.
Whew. Hottest summer we've had in years. Well, we've progressed a long way since the turn of the century 20 years ago. But no one realized then that this would be the age of electricity. Everyone's using it. Farmers, factories, whole towns. With electric streetlights, we don't worry so much about the youngsters being out after dark. And what a difference in our home. We can run as many wires as we need in any direction for Mother's new electrical service. Electric sewing machine, coffee percolator, toaster, waffle iron, refrigerator. And they all go to work at the click of a switch. Leave him alone. Well, the days of lugging heavy irons from the old cook stove to an ironing board are gone forever. With an electric iron and electric lights, Mother now has time to enjoy her embroidery in the cool of the evening. Right, Mother?
Yes, dear.
Oh, by the way, we've got a phonograph now. It's a new kind of music called jazz, and all the youngsters go for it. Crystal said Grandpa can get big time entertainment from distances up to 100 miles away. Now that's amazing news. Too bad we get so much static. I'm also getting a little static from my daughter.
I don't see any harm in my looking for a job, Daddy.
It's a man's world out there, Jane.
Well, it won't always be, Father.
Now, cut that out, Queenie. You're supposed to be man's best friend. Well, we've got indoor plumbing now. Saves a lot of walking. In our new bathroom, we've got a house guest. Cousin Orville. And as usual, he's taken over the coolest spot in the house. I will say one thing for him, though. Orville's rigged up something pretty clever. He calls it air cooling. Too bad he's not reading the help wanted ads.
No privacy at all around this place.
Sorry, Orville. You know, considering all the conveniences we have, it looks as though we've made real progress in making our lives easier. And when we read about the things those research people are working on, well, we can be sure of one thing.
Now is the time. Now is the best time. Now is the best time of your life. Life is a prize. Live every minute. Open your eyes and watch how you win it. Yesterday's memories may spark. Here and now, you've got it made. The world's forward marching and you're in the parade. Now is...
Ladies and gentlemen, please bear with us for a moment. We're having technical difficulties.
The time of joy or strife, there's so much to cheer for. Be glad you're here, for it's the best time of your life.
Hottest summer we've had in years. Well, we've progressed a long way since the turn of the century 20 years ago. But no one really embroidery is.
Jim! I watch!
I hear. So do all the neighbors. Good work, son. Sport, knock it off.
How about that? My son, the engineer. Well, okay, where was I? Oh. Remember back in the 20s when young people got their exercise dancing the Charleston? Well, today, our daughter Jane keeps in shape with electricity.
Babs, I'm having so much fun in my first year at college.
Jane, have you met any seniors yet?
Oh, dozens. And Saturday, I'm going to the dance with a real dreamboat.
Are you doing any of the new dances?
Oh, we still jitterbug. But I'm having some trouble with the rumba. I can't quite get the hip action. Oh, and listen, Babs.
more hip action and she'll disconnect something. Quiet, sports. You can never underestimate the power of a woman. And speaking of women doing things, Mother's caught up in the new do-it-yourself craze. She's remodeling our basement. It's something called a rumpus room. Mother's pretty ingenious, like using her food mixer for stirring paint. Oh, well, that's my wife, Sarah.
John?
Yes, dear?
I was just thinking.
About what?
That if you hired a man to do this, wouldn't you pay him?
Well, of course, dear.
Then I should get equal pay.
Well, we might negotiate something later on, dear.
When?
Now is the time. Now is the best time.
You stay out of this. Well, if it's time for anything, it's time to move on. And it's time to sing the song again. Come on, everybody.
Now is the time. Now is the best time. Now is the best time of your life. Life is a forest. Live every great minute. Open your eyes and watch how you've been. Yesterday's memories may sparkle and gleam. Tomorrow is still but a dream. Right here and now, you've got it made. The world's forward marching and you're in the parade. Now is the time.
You know, this is the time of day I really love. But you look at that sunset out there.
Just breathtaking.
Great way to end the great year.
Really?
Mm-hmm. It's beautiful, but I must say, having a whole family here together on this New Year's Eve is even more beautiful.
You know, dear, I think you're right.
Well, of course she is.
You tell him, Grandma.
I mean it. We're all healthy and together, and I think we're living a wonderful time.
Do you really feel that way?
The 80s are a wonderful time.
Well, I'm in the 80s myself. My gums still in that slice of
We have an awful lot to be thankful for.
Well, the old gal's right about that.
Grandpa, wait a minute. What about all those good old days of yours? The ones you're always raving about?
Yeah, they were good, all right, but I tell you, we had to spend quite a chunk of those good old days just taking care of essentials.
Oh, essentials. Glad you mentioned that. It's time for me to start my New Year's Eve spectacular. Omelette superbe avec jambon.
Not the famous omelette superbe avec jambon.
Known in other circles as ham and eggs.
Now, don't push it forward. As for you two, whatever happened to respect for your elders?
I always wondered the same thing when you were growing up.
Well, you two can ponder that age-old question. But since it's almost dark, I think I'll put your recipe on memory and throw a little light on the subject.
Oh, Mom, while you're at it, will you touch the programs again? I'd like to see the New Year's Eve celebrations in Europe and the East.
Is it that time already?
Of course. Matter of fact, it's past that time in half the world.
Wow. The awesome things they teach these children nowadays.
Very funny.
Sensational.
That's great. You know, Mother, I feel like sending up some fireworks myself.
We really do have a lot to celebrate. And not just things, either.
No, it's the whole quality of our lives.
Hey, it's great you two feel that way.
Why shouldn't we?
The world is getting more complex.
Really?
Well, today's always more complex than yesterday. Always has been.
But it's more exciting, too. Today we have so many more choices.
I think that's the best part.
Sure, today they're bringing good things to life that weren't even dreamed of a generation ago.
Oh, speaking of good things, sounds like it's time for our omelette superbe avec jambon.
See? Even sports enthusiastic about the future. All right, well, I get the message. And yes, dear, you're right. Now is the time.
Why don't we all sing it?
Now is the time. Now is the best time. Now is the best time of your life. Life is so bright. Live everything.
You can fly that your own twirling rocket to a height of 8 feet around a central tower and style them for a Saturn V launch vehicle. Phone to the entrance to Mission to Mars.
And you need a fascinating
voyage to color and cooperation from NASA. You'll blast off to witness actual close-up views of our neighbor in space, Mars. Someday, systems like the Webway
Beacon
might be developed for your own
safety. Hello.
Transportation inside buildings. While this could lead to new concepts in city planning. Here's just such an idea for a model city of the future. The tallest building would provide living, working, and shopping areas in the central location. There's even an airport and an amusement park.
See your big eyes.
Commander 2 years ago.
I know a couple kids can get in there, but I know they ain't bringing in grades like that.
Don't look so serious, Francis.
I told Mark, I said, you know what?
You got something all over your mouth.
He got a...
Oh, not you.
I made him a lieutenant when the officers in bank on there.
No, that's right. That's eating cheese on your teeth.
It cost me $400. Right out of the door, it cost me $400.
Cheese!
I bet I know somebody who
but
loves
this is the first time we can take him out in the
good.
The officers have feathers instead of just blue on the hat. And here he was right in the middle of the band with his feathers sticking up. Only way you can pick him out.
I love you. Did food just fall out?
Did you? Yes, she
did. You love you too, don't you?
We know two boys named Kate, B, and Cox, or Patrick Clement. We don't know any of them.
They're freshmen, they don't like Mark.
They're probably sophomores. Patrick would be, because he's just a Kate. Kate would be at least a junior. That's right, because Kate was, Kate, you're on with the Kate kind of didn't do real well, though, when he came home, I think he was out of control. What are you doing?
Beep, beep.
Got some all over her hands.
Beep.
Choking on that one.
I don't know your name.
No, you don't want to.
You better eat your potatoes. So we can get chicken that I cut up for you.
Let me go. I'm sitting down and relax. I like to lay down and take a nap.
I'm trying to convince her to eat. I can't believe that my voice.
Oh, I hate to hear myself.
Why do you lose my voice?
How big of a
pool?
How big of a pool do you have?
Kristen, go down. like to fancy. Searching the universe for sounds, colors, ideas, anything that sparks the imagination. A sunbeam! That's a good one. Oh! Everything I collect can inspire amazing and marvelous new ideas. And you never know what kind of figment you may come up with. Oh, here's my favorite. Two tiny wings, eyes big and yellow, horns of a spear. What a lovable fellow. From head to tail, he's loyal purple pigment. And there, voila! You've got a figment. A figment of imagination.
Big it is. on me.
First time he wasn't wearing.
Deal.
Huh? Just remember Johnny died.
Yeah, well, Christopher, get closer to Goofy. Thank you, Goofy. Look at that. Look at Jay.
Listen.
6'4", 220. Yeah, can you hear that?
Uh-huh. Well, I'm leaving. See y'all later. You have a... Kristen! Come here and give me a hug. I'm leaving.
Wait a minute. Somebody help me, Mommy.
How many more we got? Danny? 3443. Count to eight and get them more.
Kristen!
Remember that one? The pictures or movies or whatever he did back here where we kept popping in and out of the picture?
Uh-huh.
That was cute.
How many you got, Danny?
Tracy.
How many is out?
I counted 34. 34.
Got three left.
There was 32.
Anybody know where they are?
Yeah, Grandmama will be there in a little bit.
All right.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye. We'll see you.
How old was I then?
About from May 17th, about October, I forgot which fall, the fair come to Manning, and the school children, the fleet rode the bus. All the children went, and the parents, and I went on the bus and took a bottle. And Danny got a hold of the figure, and she went round there and had to pick the needs.
What about here?
He was going to school. He was in the first grade we lived on Broadway.
How old do you think I was?
Hmm?
How old do you think I was?
I'm trying to remember because you had already gone to school some when you went to Broadway.
About eight.
How old is Gloria? She was a baby when that was made there. She was a little.
Okay. How old was this? What junior senior was this? This must be the first one.
That was at Olympia School.
Must have been about 56. Let's see, that's about a 40. The 47?
Mm-hmm.
Is that a 47 Plymouth?
No, that wasn't in 47. That was in the 50s.
I know, but the car was about a 47.
Oh. I really don't know about modeling that old car. But...
Oh, that was me. Let's see, and that's a good-looking fellow with the flat top. Probably is in his early teens. How old would you say that is?
That was your senior.
Was it? I was an old teen. Okay. 1957? 58?
Well, we lived there from 52 till 59. Are you lying?
time in the pitch dark, and Jay and I are giggling, and then she said, "Well, I think I'm lost."
Well, I'm lost. Well, that guy about looks like a zombie.
Who is that?
Don't do me that bad.
She had no white hair, and she was old.
Yeah, she was in her 80s then.
It's
yeah.
a fine looking picture here.
Did you know it won't be long till I'll be 80?
Oh.
Well, you still don't look like Anna O'Shea.
Oh.
Oh, thank you. Hey, darling.
You want to go over and say hello to Aunt Sia? So we can get you on the
yeah,
microphone.
Come give me a hug. That'll
yeah.
be sweet.
No, over here.
The real one.
Yeah, come over here and hug me. And then we can see me. We can see you on TV if you come over here. Come on. Come on and give me that hug like you did when you first came in.
Come here and look back at the TV and you'll be on TV.
I got to throw this gum away.
Is it getting bad?
No, it looks bad when you choose.
Tom?
And I don't have the gum.
What did you do today?
I don't know how to
show it down. What did you do?
I did that.
I'm going to show y'all my pictures.
Oh, guess what else I got for Mother's Day?
What?
I got a certificate for a frosting.
Not that that was a hint or anything, but that's what she's been saying. She, that's what I think she said
that
she wants.
Have that.
It looks
good. I did that for my neighbor.
But
it
doesn't
look
natural.
What
was that? She can be on TV too.
Yes, there she is. Come on.
What was
come
that? My
see the dog?
I was doing
grapefruit.
That.
Come over here and hug
and
see us.
He had a box of grapefruits that they brought back from Florida.
Oh,
the first
one.
all kinds of stuff. I was taping him, and he was the funniest thing. We're going to have to.
Who was that?
My next door neighbor.
Did you show him what all he did?
Go ahead, no, that's not old thing.
Well, he did something.
He just come out
there. He held them both down, too.
And
look
you
at
got
that. Look at this young right. fella here.
He sure is nice and slim.
And you know what Tracy said last night? We had company, a couple we're friends with.
Who's that good looking girl in the shower?
And she had on her bathing suit, but a shirt on over it. They'd been laying out.
This child right here?
Yeah, that one.
With the fat little leg.
The one with the tan. Kristen.
I need a camera and I don't have it now. So.
Hey, babe.
Well,
Well, I'll tell you the truth. Out of pocket, that, this doesn't come out of Ashley Fireman. That
oh,
man.
Flat.
Bob. Kind of.
That's what it started out as?
Yeah. But they get into some real wrestling tactics.
He's got the old earlock on him.
He's been losing, so he's resorting to that. Give him the full nail.
You know, they just look so flabby, you know, that
yeah.
Right.
Well, Charlestown Landing, they had a bear down there that got a bad bite in the mouth. One of them ended up pulling, chewing the leg off the other. It was a three-legged bear.
Really?
So it died. Yeah.
Oh, God.
Yeah. Big bite. Remember that moment? Charlestown Landing?
Going for the bear.
A three-legged bear?
That's another place I like. Charlestown Landing is really good.
Y'all come on down, or we got an annual pass to the mill.
You do?
Yeah,
I love it.
Yeah,
I like to do
that.
We just give y'all our thing. Yeah.
All right.
One,
two, three.
Sheep?
Sheep? I got the sheep.